STG Repairs has served our customers since 2008 in Miami. STG Repairs team fixes almost all smartphones, tablets, and computers on the market. It also specializes in board-level repairs. Troubleshoot board-level problems. No touchscreen function, no backlight, no power. Replace knocked-off SMD components on any board. Problems with water and other liquid damage, and charging problems. We also do factory unlock, software errors, data transfer, and recovery. We have a very solid reputation in the repair community. Our clients can count on our experience. Our goal is reliable service and competitive prices.
Hello, today I'm going to show you how you can charge any battery. I'm just going to give an idea. There's many ways to do it, okay? Any battery that is almost dead. If you don't have 3.7 volts on the battery, the equipment will never turn on, okay? And will never charge. So, hoy les voy a enseñar una idea. Hay varias maneras de hacerlo. Probablemente después haga otro video. ¿Cómo levantar una batería que está menos de el voltaje que necesita, que es 3.7 voltios? Ok, si la batería no tiene 3.7 voltios o lo que requiere el equipo, que las especificaciones están en la batería, el equipo nunca va a encender y nunca va a cargar. Ok, so les voy a enseñar una manera de cómo se puede levantar la batería. We are going to use one Dell. I have, this is a Dell. This is a tablet Dell. Okay. And I'm going to show you how we are going to know this is the reason why it's not turning on. Okay. If you see, I want you guys to see the multimeter. Le voy a enseñar cómo sé que esta batería es la que no está permitiendo que encienda. Ok. Just watch the multimeter on the screen. And you can see this battery is at 3.2 voltage. Ok. So this tablet will never turn on, because it has to be 3.7, okay? So, como vieron ahí, como ven aquí, esta batería nos está marcando 3.2, so nunca va a poder encender o cargar, no importa el cargador que le pongamos, nunca lo va a cargar y no va a poder encender, okay? So, today I'm going to show you the steps, okay? This is the Dell, this is a Dell tab, okay? So it's just to give you an example, okay? It's going to work for any kind of tablet o cell phone, okay? Esto es un ejemplo, sirve para cualquier tableta o celular, okay? The first thing I did is just, I went, you know, with carefully, and I cut this plastic. Lo primero que hice fue ir con cuidado y corté el plástico, porque al tocar sé que aquí va a estar los componentes que necesito, o los contactos donde ellos son, okay? So after I cut it, I found directly ground and positive. Okay, cuando lo corto cuidadosamente para después cerrarlo, aquí encuentro positivo y tierra. Ok, so ahí es donde yo mido. Ok, so there is where I put in the tip for the multimeter. You see, there is where I put it. So now we are going to charge this battery. Okay, what the only thing we're going to need is, what you need is a multimeter, the cables that it comes with a multimeter, okay? Lo único que necesitar es el multímetro, los cables que vienen con el multímetro, que es este. I have an extra cable that I always use for many things. This cable, it has, in another video I show this cable because I already have it with a small, it's a cable here that I use to make, to apply voltage directly to the lines when they have a short. So here we are going to, on this cable that I always have for, that I use for many things, I'm going to solder one cable for positive, one negative. Aquí en este cable yo lo uso para inyectar voltaje directo a las líneas cuando tienen corto, okay? Y aquí vamos a soldar, okay, aquí vamos a soldar un cable en el positivo y en el negativo. Okay, vamos a empezar. Lo primero que vamos a hacer es soldar un cable. Sí, this is the cables, estos son los cables. Y vamos a soldar, vamos a cortar un pedazo. We're going to cut a piece. Okay, and one for positive and one for negative. It's not necessary to have two colors. Could be, you know, any cable. No es necesario tener dos colores. A mí me gusta hacerlo así para no cometer errores. Okay, it's not necessary to have, you know, two different colors. You can use any one color, but I prefer to do it like that so I don't make mistakes. Okay, so we are going to, I cut the cable and the two, you see this side and this side, and I'm going to do the same with the black one. Okay, corté el cable en los dos lados. Y voy a hacer lo mismo. Y voy a hacer lo mismo en el negro. Okay, so now we are going to solder this. We are going to solder it here. Okay, so ahora vamos a soldar este cable, el rojo, aquí. Okay, vamos a encender el mismo detector. Hay gente que prefiere los videos cortos, pero yo lo que estoy es tomándome el tiempo de explicarles, porque si le pongo fast forward, obviamente se van a demorar menos en verlo, pero la idea es que aprendan, ¿ok? There's many people, they prefer to do like fast forward on the videos. But I'm interested in you guys to learn step by step how you do this. If you don't want to see the full video, okay, this video is not for you. If you don't want to waste, you know, like, I don't know, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, this video is not going to be for you, because my purpose is to teach you how to resolve problems, okay? So as you see here, si usted no está interesado en invertir 10, 15, 20, 30 minutos en aprender, este video no es para usted, okay? Yo lo que estoy buscando es que aprenda, por eso me tomo mi tiempo, para que vean, okay? Nadie, o sea, lo que quiero es que aprendan paso a paso. So you see, this is the cable. We are going to do the same thing with the other one. Going to do the same thing with the other one. As I said before, there's many ways. You can do it the way that you like it. This is an idea. And after I give you this idea, you can use your own way. Okay. Esta es una idea solamente. Hay muchas maneras de hacerlo. Después que le di esta idea, usted lo hace de la manera que usted quiera. Ok, so now we have the two cables soldered to the alligators. Ok, now we are going to solder these two cables. We are going to solder to the battery. To the connectors, I show you. Let me turn on this so we can have more light here. Okay. So we are going to solder to ground and to the positive. Okay. Going to put flux, same thing, put flux, and then we are going to grab the soldering iron. We're going to grab the soldering iron. Let me get the soldering iron. The only thing that we are going to do now is soldering the cables. Okay, we are going to solder these cables to the battery. Lo único que vamos a hacer es soldar estos cables a la batería. Okay. Vamos al primero. Okay. This is the result. Okay. We have the alligator soldered to the cable, and then the cable soldered to each one positive and one ground. Okay. So you can see here, this other side of the cable, which is this one, what I do, I use it. If you have a, okay, in this case, because I need a longer cable because I'm doing a video, you're just going to plug this to the power supply. Right now, because I need a longer cable, I'm just going to plug the alligators here. But the only thing you're going to have to do is put this to the power supply, okay? So now, I'm going to move here. And I'm going to connect this positive. I'm going to connect to the power supply. Okay. Okay. Now I have successfully connected to the power supply. Then the multimeter, which is the other side. Here, okay. Ground, yeah. The multimeter, this alligator, we are going to connect this, which is the multimeter. Okay, so we can read the. This is unconnecting this to the multimeter, so we can know the voltage for the battery. So you can see there, we have 3.36 now, and it's going to go up 3.37. We have one thing there, so 3.37, and it's going to go up and up. So this way, you can charge any battery, and also you can be watching
how the voltage is increasing. Okay?
So, de esta manera, como ven, yo lo que hice fue conecté a los alligators donde solté el cable, okay, donde solté los cables, lo conecté a las puntas del multímetro. Y por eso que ustedes están viendo cómo el voltaje va subiendo. Ok, tengo, recuerden, el alligator, el cable del alligator conectado al power supply. Ok, y las puntas donde, o sea, el alligator soldamos unos cables directo a la batería. Y las puntas de los alligators solamente tengo las puntas del multímetro solamente para poder leer cuánto voltaje va teniendo. De esta manera ustedes van a poder levantar una batería y a la misma vez saber cuánto voltaje va obteniendo la batería. A la vez que tengamos más de 3.7, el equipo va a ser capaz de encender y volver a enfocar a su normalidad. So this way you're going to be able, the way that I'm doing this, it's not just, I'm not just charging the battery through the power supply. I'm also watching the voltage because I'm connecting my multimeter. So this way you are going to be able to bring the battery to the normal voltage, because after 3.7 the equipment is going to turn on normally and is going to be able to charge. So hopefully you enjoy this video. This is going to be very helpful for you guys. Okay, if you like, give me a like. If you don't like it, give me a comment. Pero que este video sé que le va a ser muy útil a muchos de ustedes que se dedican a esto. Si tienen algún comentario, háganmelo saber. Y si les gustó el video, denme un like. Gracias.